This is a list of parts I need to make. And this is part number one, which is probably the most complex part I've designed and made so far. This time I'm gonna start a really complicated project. And I can tell you that this project was really challenging. Here's the plan. I want to build a reliable, customizable, and portable light source for the workshop. Having collected all the necessary components, it all started with designing. I designed this assembly in SolidWorks, which wasn't difficult. And thanks to this project, I learned many interesting features of this CAD. To show you clearly, I made a step-by-step visualization of the entire assembly and then made several renders. And you might think to yourself, you can buy a softbox in a store and not waste time making it yourself. On the one hand, you're right, but that is not the point. The goal is to put all my practical skills into this project, from engineering, design, metalworking, electronics, to filming and video editing. Everything is done in order to become one step higher professionally and to share all my experience with you and, of course, to make content. Make sure you're subscribed, and in the meantime, I'll bring this project to life. It all started with the fact that I had a CPU cooling fan. Now we need to carefully disassemble it. And while I was disassembling it, I already had an idea how to organize the mounting, but more on that later. As you can see, the LED matrix fits perfectly into this heatsink. We have these fixtures here. I don't really mind it that much, but it would be better to cut them off. The LED driver will be mounted on the back like this. After wiping the thermal paste off, let's start cutting the fixtures off. I'll use my cold saw for this operation. Next, I smooth out the rough edges. Now we need to drill the mounting holes for the LED matrix and tap the threads. This 70 watt neutral light LED matrix is commonly used for street lighting. I chose it because it's compact and moisture resistant. Once the drilling was done, I started cutting the threads. I should be careful not to break the tap. Now the heatsink is completely ready for further assembly. The next part of the lamp that needs to be made from scratch is the reflector. I print the templates that will help me cut out the parts more easily. I chose stainless steel as the material for these parts. I add some glue and stick these templates on the surface of the steel, then roll and let them dry. After, I just mark the holes and cut the parts out with an angle grinder. Scratch the fold lines so as not to lose them. Finally, all the parts are finished and it's time to get out the sheet metal bender and bend them to its shape. After I have bent them, I proceed to welding. I make two tacks from both sides. The metal is only 1 millimeter thick, so it would be a good idea to put a piece of metal underneath to dissipate heat. I'm going to weld them together in pulse mode with no filler and run the torch fast. This will prevent the metal from overheating. The welds came out pretty good. I need to clamp these two parts together and at the same time to have access to weld from the inside. For this task, this plywood circle is perfect. For better light scattering, I make a texture with a carbide burr.
One hour later.
After all, I do some polishing and grinding. And at the very end, in order to make the scratches invisible, I use a homemade tool made out of Scotch-Brite and a burr stone to apply a circular texture. I'm not really sure that this part turned out perfect, but I can confidently say that it'll perform its function well. In order to fit the LED driver in the lamp, we need to make a housing for it. I'm taking a standard 50 by 50 millimeter metal tube and cutting off a part of it with a cold saw. If you want to see a review of this saw, let me know in the comments. During the testing of the LED matrix, I discovered that passive cooling is not enough. There must be a cooling fan integrated into the housing. To ensure proper airflow, I'm adding a perforation pattern. Then I drill a lot of holes so that air can get through them and reach the heatsink. Once the holes are in place, I take the time to chamfer them. I apply cutting fluid and start tapping, making sure it's square every time. A sharp burr might not seem like much, but it can interfere with cables, airflow, or worse, injure hands during assembly. So I decided to eliminate them completely using a power file. This is the final piece. Clear lines, precise geometry, and a shiny surface. Each thread is tapped cleanly, ready to accept screws and fasteners with perfect alignment. In the next part, I'll be making the remaining components, and of course, I'll be testing the LED matrix to see how it performs in real conditions. And I'll also show you how I solved the problem with adjusting the light brightness. If you're curious to see how it all comes together, make sure to subscribe. There's a lot more hands-on work, smart engineering, and creative problem solving to come.